Fisheries Eye is supported by the USAID from the American people. It's the legacy of their forefathers, handed down from generation to generation. A tradition deeply built in custom and belief. Here in the Sekandine Rishia community, fishing evidently plays a critical role in their society. For decades, age-old fishing techniques, stories, and rituals have been inherited, forging a strong sense of identity and unity. Centuries of traditional fishing have supported coastal economies, cultures, and environments. But current fishing practices are now a stark difference from the norm. Kwesi Kakra is arguably one of the oldest fishermen at a Nurusia landing beach. Over the years, he's gathered significant skills and experience. For Kwesi, the current decline in fish stock is worrying. Methods like the use of dynamite and light fishing are threatening the very existence of the fish. Kabuna Isin has been fishing in this community for over 30 years.
First, no, and I'm no say all the brothers now. It do bony be an canoe, and I'm about to my barber there. And see, you're blow on the channel. Then, so she's the abbey groom in there. And there was the demo runs, one which runs, was the light, and all the chinaman, and say, and I'm no, in short, but as I, you know, wait till you know. What gentleman was sorry? What gentleman was sorry? Say, watching a mammy, watching a papa, watching an anna, watching an ancansua, Baka, but yet, and kissing, kissing, watch one. It's up and I'm now. And I'm also what Bibian come on with that grab at as I, and every day, the more you know, let you know what you want and say, Ubune, who there, baby walk on.
Kwesi
That's not the upperman, which we know within college, you know. Yes, and Sanka. And said, I'm a rance now. I want the more you know. I want a next mutual rance. I want one second. And so, what's the cash? The boom is there. And got coming in. What I said, what to toy, what you will be behind you.
Angered at the increase in illegal fishing practices in present times, he says government authorities are not doing enough to stop it. Over the past years, Ghana has seen a huge decline in its marine resources, particularly fish. The devastating consequences of the use of light, dynamite, and illegal nets in fishing threaten the very existence of the fishing industry. Light fishing lures juvenile fish, disrupting the already delicate marine system, but the use of dynamite for fishing has an even deadlier effect. It not only destroys fish, but also targets other marine life. Effect: depleted fish stock, loss of biodiversity, and environmental contamination. Coastal communities that depend on fish for their livelihood suffer greatly. Here at Inuashia Landing Beach, fishermen are changing the narrative. Upon seeing the negative effects of illegal fishing practices, fishermen have decided to put a stop to the menace.
Wow, like a bit
Nanakan is chief fisherman here at Inuashia Landing Beach. He oversees all fishing activities and ensures fishermen are adhering to safe fishing practices.
Light no che wa de onu abe me do ga na yakwa ho. Adom me mbeche adom me nyana mu efo ehwa embre ni nyana. O ma na situ. Nemu da bo fu onyin nu ada wood ni ogbo ho ba.
The decline of indigenous knowledge has led to overfishing and decreased biodiversity. The Fisheries Commission in Sekondi says it is doing everything in its power to maintain adherence to safe fishing practices.
We're actually working tirelessly, actually in Sekondi. Yeah, we are working tirelessly. You know, when something has been in a norm, or has happened for quite a long time, stopping it at a time is a bit difficult. It will take time. But then the Fisheries Commission and our mother ministry, the MUFAD, we are relentless in fighting to help bring light fishing under control.
Assistant Fisheries Manager in Sekondi, Michael Aban, however, says managing the large number of fishermen on the landing beaches is a difficult task.
fishing with lights and other things that aggregate fishes to come to the surface for you to actually catch is illegal. It's against the law, Fisheries Act, it's against our act, our regulations, it's stated there. So what happens is that currently with the FEU, that's the Fisheries Enforcement Unit, they are mandated actually to help and control and regulate this. So by law, they are supposed to make the arrest. They make the arrest and they process you for court. So all perpetrators of these acts are actually arrested and then they are processed for court. What we in the commission are also doing is that we educate, we sensitize them from time to time with our daily activities. Whenever we come to the landing beaches to take our report, to take our daily reports, we also educate them and encourage them to desist from acts that are concerned within this light fishing that we're talking about.
Sustainable Development Goal 14.2 requires the management and protection of marine and coastal ecosystems to achieve healthy and productive oceans. In addition, SDG 14.4 requires effective regulation of harvesting and an end to overfishing. With barely 6 years left to attain the 2030 Sustainable Development Goals, Ghana certainly needs to do more to achieve this target. Judith Brown for The Assignment. Fisheries Eye is supported by the USAID from the American people.